finally, Apple are now allowing us to share folders directly from iCloud. Whoa, did it take a long time for that to come through. We were promised this last September when they launched iOS 13 and Mac OS Catalina. It didn't come, but finally this week it has arrived with the latest update to iOS 13, iOS 13.4. So before I do go any further, I should say that this is only going to work if you've upgraded your Catalina to the very latest version of Catalina and you've updated your iOS devices, including iPad, to the very latest version. That's iOS 13.4. Okay, now what this basically allows you to do is now not only can you just select a document and share that, you can now also share a folder of documents directly to a colleague, a partner, or whoever you want to share it with. And this week I'm going to show you how to do that both in OS Catalina and also on your iPhone. Now, before we go any further, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by hitting that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks and news on using Apple's productivity suite of applications, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, it's now time for me to take you into my iCloud and show you how to set all this up. Okay, so here we have my iCloud folder on my Mac, and I'm going to start with Mac and then we'll show you how to do this on your iPhone. So we're in my iCloud drive here, and let's say that I want to share my workshops folder right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to control click on that and I'm going to go down to share. And what you're looking for is the add people icon. So hit on add people. And the first thing you want to do is you want to share this who can access. Now, this depends. If it's going to be people that you invite, then you don't want to change that. But I'm going to change that to anyone with the link. And I'm going to leave the permissions with. You can change the permissions to view only or make changes. Once I've done that, I'm going to hit copy link. And then I'm going to hit share. And what that's going to do is that's now given me a copy of the link. So if I open up drafts on my computer, so let's just hit drafts, and I can now just, this was my testing, I can type in that, and sure enough, that is now the iCode. So I've now got the link that I can now share with other people. So that's essentially how to do it. Now, one of the wonderful things about iCloud is that you actually now get this little icon here that shows that it's shared. Now, I also have another one here, which is my miscellaneous teaching materials. I've shared that with one of my co-teachers. And you can see now indicates that the folder changes as to how you are to tell you which files you are sharing. So there you go. That's how you do it on the Mac. Let me now show you how you do this on your iPhone. Okay, quick tip before we get started here. If you don't like to see this layout, the folders, what you can do is if you pull down, I'll show you, if you pull down, you can see sort by name, but actually you can tap these arrows right there and you can actually have this folder layout. So that's just a quick tip for you if you wanted to use that there. Right, so let's go back into this. Now I've got my 2020 class materials there. Let's decide that this is the folder that I want to share. So we'll tap on that and we can, sorry, we do select, tap on that, and you'll go down at the bottom and you can see down in the bottom left hand corner the share sheet. Now again, we've got class materials. What I want to do is go down to add people. So once I've done that, now I can actually share this how I want. So we've got all sorts of various options here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go down here and I'm going to, anyone with the link again can make changes. So I've done that. The thing is, as you can see here now, I don't have the options that I thought I would have. So what I'm going to do is, once again, I'm going to use drafts. That's now going to share the link to my drafts. And I can now save that in drafts, and that is saved. If I go into my drafts app here and down over here, you can see that that is now there. And that's it. That's basically all you need to know to share your files using iCloud, using the files option in iCloud. It's really quite simple, and it's not as easy, to be fair, as using Google Drive, which is one of the reasons why I actually do have Google Drive on my computer. simply because I find that much easier. But if you're working with somebody who is in the Apple ecosystem, like say your partner or your colleagues or something, then this is actually now you can, it's great that we can actually share folders using our iCloud. So there you go. I hope you found this episode useful. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you for watching this video. Now, if you have enjoyed these Apple videos that I'm doing and you want to build your very own Apple productivity system, then please check out my Create Your Own Apple Productivity System course, which is available from my learning center and is incredible value, and it will show you how to bring all these parts together, the Notes app, iCloud, reminders and calendar, into one beautiful productivity system. Check out the course here. The details are below, and I hope to see you in the course.